Hey guys, today we will transform this scene in Unity to look like this by using the Aura 2 volumetric lighting. I made this tutorial for one of the best assets on the Unity Asset Store, Aura 2 Volumetric Lighting and Fog, made by Oneric Studio. If you want to follow along, you must have Aura 2 in your assets library. I enjoy using it, and I would highly recommend this asset for those looking for the best volumetric lighting solution for Unity standard 3D pipeline. Aura 2 link in the video description. First, you must create a 3D standard Unity project. I recommend using Unity 2020.1 or newer. I'm using Unity 2020.3 LTS. If you want to follow along, go to Assets, Import Package, Custom Package, and import Sample Scene Unity Package. Download link in the video description. Load the sample scene if not loaded. Here we have an interior scene that we will be using to test volumetric lighting. The scene has baked lighting. By using these settings, it has one directional light called sun and post-processing volume, which is used for post-processing. To enable it, go to Window Package Manager. Unity Registry, search for post-processing and install it. If after install you get an error message, save your project and restart Unity. Now the post-processing effects should work. If it still doesn't work, select the camera, add layer, I will call it post. Select the camera and apply post to the post process layer. Select the post processing volume and apply post layer. Now post processing effects should work. Go to Edit, Project Settings, Player tab, Other Settings, and set the color space to linear to improve colors. Look how nice and vibrant the colors are. Go to Window, Package Manager, My Assets, search for Aura 2. Aura 2 is a paid asset from the Unity Asset Store. You must have it in your Unity Assets library to use it. You can get it from the Unity Asset Store. Aura 2 link in the video description. Select Aura 2 and import. After your first time importing it, you should get a welcome screen. Read through all of it to learn about Aura 2 basics. On the left side, we have an Aura 2 scene tab. Click on the Display Presets button. Here we can choose the Aura Ambience preset and apply volumetric lighting to our scene in just one click. Remember that if you apply any preset, it will override the directional light settings in your scene, like rotation, color, and lighting intensity. I don't want to lose my sun settings, so I will hide it. Now, instead of overwriting my directional light settings, Aura preset will create a new directional light. So let's click on a down preset. And here we have volumetric lighting working out of the box. We have a nice fog and light shafts. Preset added three components. Aura camera component to the camera. Aura directional light with a Aura light component. And Aura preset volume with a Aura volume component. All of these components control Aura 2 volumetric lighting. If you rotate the Aura directional light, which has Aura light component, it will move light shafts too. Let's remove Aura volumetric lighting and set up it manually. To remove Aura volumetric lighting from your scene, first delete Aura camera component. Delete Aura directional light, which has Aura light component. And delete Aura preset volume, which has Aura volume component. Now we have a scene without volumetric lighting, like before. Also, let's enable the sun. Select the camera. Add component Aura 2. Here we have all Aura 2 components. Click on Aura camera. Remove it. We can add the same components using Aura 2 menu here. Or by using a plus symbol on the game object. Click on it to add Aura camera component. Here we have the main settings of the volumetric lighting. If you look at the scene, we have volumetric fog, but no light shafts. Here we can change things like fog density, ambient light color, and more, which I will cover later on. For now, let's leave everything at the default settings. Select the sun, our directional light. It must be real time, so you can apply light shafts. Click on the plus to add Aura light. Here we have Aura light settings. Now our scene has very soft light shafts. If we increase light intensity, light shaft intensity will increase too. Since I don't want to make my sun too intense, I will leave it at 2.5. And instead, we can change our light strength to control light shafts. 2 works pretty good. You can see that if I move the camera to the other side, we can't see the light shafts at all. We can set the strength to a bigger value. We can see them, but we will run into a few problems. Let's open the game view. Set the strength to 50 and click on the game view to update the changes. Every time you change something in our settings, click on the game view to fully update the changes. Open the scene view. Keep in mind that the quality of the volumetric lighting in the scene view is reduced to make it more smooth to work with. And in the game view, it looks the same you will see in the game build. Okay, so if we use the high strength value like 50, light shafts will be way too intense while looking from the light direction. If we select the camera and change the field of view to a lower value like 40, light shafts will fog up the screen. Same applies to the physical camera focal length. To fix these problems, set our light strength to as low as 1 or something like that. Now the camera won't fog up that much. So I will leave the strength at 1. And to make light shafts visible from the other side, enable out of phase color. Set its strength to 50 and the color to something like this. Select the camera. Go to Aura 2, examples, sources, scripts. Drag and drop Aura 3 camera script to the camera to apply. Disable camera control script. And check free look enabled on the Aura 3 camera script. Sometimes using Aura 2, the screen can go white. To fix that, just press play. Now by using WASD and mouse, we can control the camera. If you look closely, light rays are cut into two colors. And there is a very noticeable seam in between those two colors. We can fix that. Disable the play mode. Select the camera. Let's open the scene view. For some reason, volumetric lighting doesn't show up for me. If it happens for you, press on the effects toggle 2 times. And if it doesn't help, press on play 2 times. Okay, let's continue. So, to fix that light seam, set scattering to 1. Now light ray colors have a nice and smooth gradient. Select the sun. Enable override color. And change the first light shaft color, which is coming from the window. I will set mine to a sky color. Press play and check how it looks. I really like that light shaft's gradient. So, this is the first color, and here is the second color. I am happy with these settings. Select the camera and set ambient light to 0.1, so the scene is not so foggy. Enable light. Here you can change the fog color. I will set mine to orange. And set the strength to 0.5. Let's create Aura 2, volume, global. Select the Aura global volume. Reset the transform. For now, let's disable the density. and enable the boost to increase the light shaft's intensity. Set it to 2. Press play. Just look at those god rays. Quit play mode. Enable the density. Set it to 0.5. And enable the noise mask. If you look closely, we have a fog noise animation going on. I will change the noise speed to 1 so you can see it better. You can also change the noise scale. I will leave the scale and the speed at the default settings. I like the default noise effect. Now, if you go to the density settings, you can customize the noise levels. Also, you have some noise customization inside the boost settings. Select the camera and enable extinction. It lets you control the overall volumetric lighting effect. If you set it to 0, volumetric lighting will be gone. I will set mine to 0.5. Press on play and let's see how it looks. I love those god rays. If you look at the ceiling, we have that strange looking noisy fog, and I don't want that. So let's fix it. Select the aura global volume and look where it says shape. Open the scene view. Here is our global aura volume, which means it affects the whole scene. Let's change the shape to box. Here we have a little box in our scene. Aura volume effects will only work inside this box. Use the move tool to move the box. Click on this camera icon to disable volumetric lighting to see everything easier. Go to the top view. And move the box to the center of the scene. Change the X and Z axis so the box covers the building. I will set it to 40. Go to the side view and change the Y axis so the box will cover the walls of the building. Don't cover the roof so we can rid of that strange looking noisy fog we had on the ceiling before. Enable volumetric lighting. Open the game view, press play. You can see that the light rays and the fog are looking faded. And we get rid of that strange noisy fog on the ceiling. Select the aura global volume and increase the light rays boost. I set mine to 20. Press play. Light rays are looking good. Let's also increase the volumetric fog a bit. Select the camera lower down the extinction to something like 0.2. Now everything looks just like before, setting up the volume box. Disable Aura Free camera and enable my camera control script. Press play. Everything looks nice, but we have some flickering going on. Look at those two little windows on the left. They are flickering. Let's fix that. Select the camera, open the quality settings, make sure that enable occlusion cooling is ticked and set accuracy to medium or higher. For me, medium works perfectly. Press play. We have no more flickering going on. We can also increase light rays quality. Again, open the quality settings and where it says grid, multiply all numbers by 2. And now our light rays became god rays with a double resolution. Open the VFX folder, drag and drop particle system to the hierarchy, open the game view. You can see that we have some floating particle effects, which are not affected by volumetric lighting. We can improve that by applying our shader to the particle system. Select the particle system. Here we have a default particle shader applied. Change it to Aura 2, Particles, Additive. Press play. Look how nice particles are affected by volumetric lighting. It looks absolutely amazing. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and found it helpful. I highly recommend Aura 2 because I think it is the best volumetric lighting solution for Unity. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more.